demonstrated that everyone here has a purpose. You have demonstrated that everyone has meaning. And no one person is better or more important than another. Whether it's a full-timer or a part-timer, whether it's a sacker or a cashier, or a grocery clerk, or a truck driver, or a warehouse selector, a store manager, a supervisor, a customer, a vendor, or a CEO, we are all equal.
That was the CEO of Market Basket Grocery Store in Massachusetts addressing the company's employees in a speech that has gotten widespread acclaim.
Look at those employees. It's
this nice. Was their reaction watching him on TV. Passionate employees picketed for weeks to bring Arthur T. Demoulas back amid a bitter corporate dispute. It worked. And late Wednesday, a deal was struck to return him as CEO. People in the crowd shouted, "We love you," as the RDT, as he's known, told them how special they were and how much he loved them. That's really nice.
It really is unbelievable. And here you have on the front of the Boston Globe, I was doing research. You know, I was on assignment in Cape Cod for a couple of months this summer. And this story was on the front page of the paper. The thing that shocked me about it is it's a New England story, but it's much bigger than that. This is a universal story about how leaders can actually be servants, leader servants. You get, I mean, we live in an age where the rich keep getting richer, the poor keep getting poorer, income inequality spreads out, CEO pay explodes, workers' pays are flattened. You never hear workers talking about their CEO or fighting or actually going out and picket lines for the CEOs like they are for RDT. It's unbelievable.
It was an incredible bit of labor organizing without a union component to it, which made it remarkable. And there was this whole inter-family dynamic to this where his cousin had bought him out and everyone loved him and they wanted him back. And it shows that you can organize for better worker conditions and that you can be a CEO and not be a total jerk.
Yeah.
And that companies can work based on mutual affection and trust.
Look at the affection they have for this man. Who's the CEO? They really do feel like it's a team.
I just want to stress, these workers put so much on the line for this. They risk their jobs. They risk weeks, if not months, of paycheck, of health care coverage, all to make sure that their company worked cohesively again. And
it's a wonderful story. It's a beautiful story. Mika, also, you know what I love? I love when people admit that they make a mistake. Now, I'm, of course, forced to admit that I make mistakes.